people of Earth, how are you?
Hell yeah, people, we are live, people, we are live. Garage Oldies time. A little late, but we're here, people, we're here. Elaine Martinez, saludos. Shorty in the house, what's happening? There's Martin in the background. Veronica, there's the wifey back there. Saludos. Joan Murgo, saludos. Michelle, what's happening? Saludos, people. Rudy Marufa, what's happening? Albert Vescara, what's happening? Saludos, saludos. We got a special show tonight, people. Hell yeah. Lillian Medina, what's happening? John Moodroars, Boogie Down Bronx in the house. You guys ready for some garage? All these guys gotta go out there and share, share, and share. Terry Castillo, hell yeah. Jerry Moya, what's happening? Coral, what's happening? Saludos. Tommy Raider, what's happening? Raider Tommy, how you doing, brother? Lenny Rios, Shorty, Jose and Sonia Jimenez, what's happening? Joan Burgos says hi to Wi-Fi. He's out there hiding out. Mary Canedo, what's happening? Guerra Madrid, saludos, saludos. How's everybody doing tonight? How's everybody doing tonight? Junior Perez, what's happening? Listen, saludos, Angelina. Hell yeah. Nadine, saludos. George Torres, what's happening? Saludos, saludos. And the wife said saludos, everybody. Patricia, saludos. Lydia Rios, what's happening? Happy Friday, happy Friday. Linda, hell yeah. Juan Carrillo, saludos. Felipa, ¿cómo estás? Mike Jones, what's happening, brother? David Luna, Lamas. Terry, what's happening? Hell yeah. B Zundiga, what's happening, B? Hell yeah. You guys ready for a good night? Garage all these time, people. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, Raider Tommy. Should have been here, brother. Erica Valenzuela, ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? Hell yeah. We got people here. We got a great show lined up. David Garcia, what's happening, brother? Pete Rodriguez, what's happening? El Paso, Texas, how you doing? Maria, ¿cómo estás? Javier Juarez, what's happening, brother? Cholo Challenge in the house. Joey Jam Flores, what's happening? Cisco Kid, what's happening, brother? Roxy Santos, saludos. Hell yeah. David Luna, ¿cómo estás? Saludos. John Allen, what's happening, brother? What's happening? Rocio, ¿cómo estás, prima? Christine Martinez, what's happening? What's happening? Laura Flores, how you doing? How you doing? Estella Rangel, saludos. Everybody go share, share, and share, people. Kathy Mares, San Fernando, ¿cómo estás? Vincent Gonzalez, Humberto Fenmat, saludos, brother. Hell yeah, Joey Jam Flores, how you doing, brother? Cisco Kid in the house. Oops, sorry about that. That was my fault.
People of Earth, how are you? Okay.
Jose Lopez, what's happening? Kathy Mares, saludos. Laura Flores, saludos. Alex Moreno, what's happening? Saludos, saludos. Mario Moncada, how you doing, brother? Art, what? Valderas, saludos. Jorge Ramirez, East Los. Nancy Garcia, 209 in the house. Oh, Dad, what's happening, brother? Sorry to hear that, Joey. Prayers, man. Mariah Avila in the house. Saludos, Mariah. ¿Cómo estás? Check it out, check it out. Hell yeah. Blanca Bobby D presents. How you doing, Blanca?
I'm doing good.
Hell yeah.
I didn't know how to come in here, so I had to make a little dance. What's up, everybody? How you guys doing tonight?
We got Blanca Bobby D presents in the house. How you doing, Blanca?
I'm doing good.
Finally get to meet you.
Hell yeah.
Finally. Tell everyone why you guys are all here today.
Okay, so today we are here because we have a special guest.
Yeah, who's that special guest?
Should we roll him in here?
too soon.
I love him very much. You know, he's part of my street team, but he's one of my comedians for all my shows. You already know, I do my own shows are Sky Presents, Sky Events and Entertainment. So, you know, he's always doing comedy for me, the hosting, and we got Joe El Cholo.
What's up? That's right, they roll me in here, man.
Hell yeah.
I'm just being lazy, homie. I figured, you know what? What better way than a cholo to get rolled in? You know? You see me rolling. You know what? I just tried out for Dancing with the Stars, homie. Ni modo, homie, you know what I'm saying? They had one leg on me.
You know, Henry, they said, how do we walk into the show? You know? We don't walk, we roll through.
Roll on in.
Yeah, that's how I roll. That's how I roll. Don't forget, guys, we got two other comedians, two men bringing down the house. We got Bobby Guzman. Where you at, Bobby?
Got Bobby G. There's little puppet in the background.
You got the, yeah, they got the puppet.
What do you got to say, puppet? Oh, he ain't got nothing to say yet.
Don't look at me, little puppet.
Not yet. Don't look.
Hey, what's happening, everybody? Bobby G in the house along with little here. So, everybody, are you excited? We're going to have a good time. We're having a fundraiser for Joe El Cholo. We're raising money to help him out. As you know, he's a double amputee. He's not ashamed of it. You know, he's still standing, though, regardless.
That's right.
He's still standing. Hey, you know what? Henry, I brought you a little gift, all right?
What's that?
Hold on, here you go, homie. I mean, because you never know, man. You know, the coronavirus is going to hit big again. So I want you to be prepared, right?
I'm prepared. Thank you,
brother. That's right. So I will be here later on and do some comedy for you guys. But here's Joe El Cholo, right?
Henry,
yes.
I think he gave you that toilet paper
because
you're the shit.
Oh, hey,
I got another comedian.
Just so you guys know, he's selling it for $9.99.
Hey, all for a good cause.
All for a good cause. Like, also, too, man, we have the special comedian, man. We got Richard Pia, man.
Yeah. How's it going, everybody? Hey, Henry, thank you very much for having me in your garage. This is amazing. People, if you don't know, this is really a fucking garage.
It's a garage.
This is a garage. Like, there's a pink bug on the other side of this mountain. I've known Joe since he had two legs, bro. That's how long we've been friends.
Oh, my God. I don't know. See, I rolled you through. But he just, I don't know what he just did.
But not only that, man, we also got a special guest for you, a singer by the name of Susie.
Susie.
Hi, guys. We got Susie Moran in the house.
Live in a garage, which is true. We took the scary scenic route over here. We thought we were going to die. The show's in the corner. Okay.
Oh, this little puppet. Hell yeah.
You guys, you already know we're going to be announcing this throughout the show. But go to the GoFundMe for Joe El Cholo. Yeah. We are raising money. Please, you guys, go there. We are going to be stating this throughout the whole night. We also have a raffle fundraiser. We got three prizes. I have put them on my page. Joe has as well. There's more merch and more things that have been added, including from Bella Bella. She's actually doing a makeover. So makeup makeover is added. Henry Lozano has been added. He gave a couple of shirts also for his garage and all these. And do we have anybody else?
Oh, we have elotes.
Show.
Hey, that's the country life, man. We ain't big city folks like you guys.
Look at, we got the elotes right here.
We got corn, people. Children of the corn.
A whole box.
Hell yeah.
All right, you guys, so I'm going to move away for a little bit, but I'm going to leave you here with Joe El Cholo and Henry Lozano at his Garage Oldies show.
Hell yeah. Gracias.
Don't forget, guys, to start sharing. Sharing is caring, everybody.
Yeah, so sharing is caring, people.
Sharing it, man. Right here, man. Hey, little puppet. Let him know what's up, little puppet.
All right, what's happening? Hey, Henry, where's all the Barbies at, eh? Any Barbies in the house? I'll settle for a Brett doll. Well, anyways, we're having a fundraiser, as you can be a part of this fundraiser for Joe El Cholo. Because if you don't, guess what? I'm going to go looking for you, SN. That's right, I'll be looking for you. So, little puppet, how you been? Nah, I've been all right, homie. So, I heard you got married. Well, I was supposed to get married, but the hyena left me at the altar, eh? What? Yeah, she left me at the altar. Well, what happened, little puppet? Man, she said, you know what? I want to do something special in our wedding. I want to do our own personal vows. Oh, yeah, so what happened? Well, she did her vows, and they were nice. And then it was my turn to say my vows. So what happened? Well, I said my vows, and she got mad. Well, why was that? Because I said my vows. I said, A-I-O-U, and she got all muitado, man. I think I said them pretty good. And she left me at the altar, eh? Yeah, that's got to. I know. Tell me about it. But, yeah, you know what, Andrea? It's crazy, man, because I went, before I came over here, I went to the Cholo Mall, well, the swap meet, actually. And, you know, there's a lot of Cholos at the Cholo Mall. And I was walking, and this vato was mad-dogging me. You know, he's looking at me, mad-dogging me, and I'm like, man, I'm too old to fight, right? My arthritis will kick in, you know, I might faint. He's going, what are you looking at? So I'm like, what am I doing wrong? He got mad, Henry, and I was Henry looking at him. I was looking at his old lady, man. And he got out with Dago, eh? I'm telling you, man, these cholos. But I'll tell you guys, if a guy looks at your old lady, don't get mad. Be happy. Say, you know what? That's right. You're checking on my old lady, but she's with me. Now, if a vato doesn't check on your old lady, then get mad. Say, well, what's wrong, eh? What, my old lady not fine enough for you or what? Didn't get mad. But yeah, these cholos are too much. And people think I'm a cholo, but I'm a retired cholo. You know what I mean? I'm a retired cholo. You know, I do a drive-by once in a while on an Uber. You know what I mean? But I'm a retired cholo. And I went to Virginia. You know what's in Virginia, right? A lot of racism. A lot of white people. So I went to Virginia, and this white guy goes, hey, are you one of them cholo critters? I said, excuse me? He goes, are you one of them cholo critters? I guess I'm a retired cholo. He goes, man, I only see you guys on Cops, and that's all. I never seen a real cholo in real life. Can I take a picture of you? And I said, sure, go ahead, man. He comes, he takes a picture of me, he calls his family, he goes, hey, you gotta come, Betty Sue, there's a real cholo right here in Virginia, man. So all kinds of white people are all around me, man, taking photos of me. The mayor came and gave me the keys to the city and everything, man. I'm telling you, I was just waiting for the burning cross, man, because there was a bunch of white people, you know. But like I said, I am a retired cholo. And you know, when you're a cholo, you get violent, right? Especially when you drink. Anybody get violent when they drink? Huh? And you know, when you're drunk, the truth comes out of you, right? So I used to get drunk. I used to get crazy. And I used to get in fights. And every time I would get in a fight, I always lose. I mean, you know, they were pretty big. The women were pretty big, man. So I never won the fight. And one time I said, you know what? I'm going to pick on this vato, man. Maybe, you know, I'll win the fight. So I said, the first guy that comes in, I'm going to hit him up. I said, hey, let's take it over the alley. And he's just looking at me. I go, that's right. I'm talking to you, fool. Let's take it over the alley. So, you know, it was a gentleman that rolled him on his wheelchair to the alley. And he still beat me up, man. I never win a fight. That's the story of my life, man. You know, but we are here, like I said, to support Joel Cholo. Everybody knows Joel Cholo is a good guy. I met him personally maybe 2 years ago, but I knew him for the longest time. You know what? He know me since back in the days when I was strung out on heroin. He goes, I remember you in the neighborhood. He goes, when you were strung out on heroin. And we became good friends. So you know what? I came over here to support him. So you know what? Come and support and be a part of this, all right? And I'll be here later on, and we're going to talk some more. So, all right, give it up for Joel Cholo, all right?
Hell all yeah. Right,
yeah.
Give it up for Bobby G.
All right, thank you.
Hell yeah.
I became the hostess all of a sudden to your show. All right, you guys, give him a big hand, Bobby G. Pull up a chair, pull up a chair. We're on live. Say hi to everybody on Instagram, Henry.
Hello. Hell yeah.
So you guys, Henry is on Facebook Live. We're going to figure out how to connect him to Instagram Live too. But on Facebook Live, we have 115 people right now logged in. They come and they go. But let's give a couple of shout-outs. Go ahead, Henry.
Sylvia Martinez Morales. Saludos, Tina Castro. What's happening? Hell yeah. You guys get ready for a fun night. Laughs and oldies. Hell yeah. Donna Fimenez. Saludos, Willie Valdez. What's happening? Cindy Cox. Amarillo Teja.
All right, well, we're going to have collection time. It's time to collect some funds for Joel Cholo. So reach into your pockets. It's time to give an offering to Joel Cholo. Here we go. Here's my offering basket. All right? So it's time to give. EBT cards accepted, pin numbers, whatever. There you go. It's time to give. So we're going to give to Cholo, right, Joel Cholo? So here's the offering basket, so we'll leave it here, and we'll see how full it gets by the end of this show. Yeah, that's right.
AB, what's happening? AB, Bochocha, it says, where's Joe at?
He's Joe, they want you, Joe.
All right, Joe, they want you, Joe.
They want Joe
come
on camera.
Come and do a little bit of an appearance. So you guys, don't forget, Joe has a GoFundMe account. So go ahead and go and do some donations, you guys. You guys, once you put your name on there, don't worry. We're also going to include you in the raffle. So the GoFundMe account is Joe El Cholo GoFundMe.
Joe El Cholo GoFundMe. All right. So donate, give from your heart. Give whatever you can give. No, nothing's too small, nothing's too big, right?
There's Joe right there. Yo, yo, yo. What's happening, AB? Salud.
What's up,
hell
AB?
Yeah.
Right. Don't forget, guys, buy your raffle tickets. They're only $20, man. Not only that, but the first prize, man, is incredible. You get your own personal comedy show at your house, man. So me, my friends are going to come and steal a little bit. Nah, just kidding. We won't steal, man. Nah, we don't need it. I told you, eh? You know what I'm saying? We're gonna steal hearts. and a leg. If I can get a leg, eh? We're gonna steal a leg. says, Ember, if you're gonna pay with EBT, I'm gonna charge a little extra. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna.
Yeah, for every 20, it's a 10. For every 100, it's a 50. You know how it works, right?
We gotta collect, eh? You little, you know, EBT, man. We take EBT. Remember, eat better today. You know what I'm saying? What's up, Becky, out there? Lilian, what's up, everybody, man? Don't forget, man, how can they find to buy a raffle ticket?
All right, so they can. If you want to buy a raffle ticket, you guys can go ahead and send me a message, Blanca, on Bobby D Presents on Facebook or Sky underscore Cast 68 on Instagram or Blanca Bobby D Presents. Yeah, and that's how you can buy it. We're gonna have a portrait, all kinds of stuff, you know. And then we'll mention everybody that has actually donated and has been a big part of this.
And don't forget, guys, if you don't know what a cholo is a Mexican Boy Scout. That's what a cholo is, okay? I don't want you guys to get scared and be like, you don't understand. No, a cholo is a Mexican Boy Scout. The difference is...
We don't get touched.
Well, oh, snap.
I'm sorry. Sorry, Andy.
Woo! Well, besides getting touched, man.
Too far.
Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, Cholo's the, we get mad, we don't get touched.
We'll stab you, fucker.
Yeah, anyway, you know. Remember, guys. All up in my face, homie.
Sorry, Henry.
I started choking. Don't forget, guys. The difference is they get patches. Well, actually, they get patches. We get tattoos, man. So that's what I'm telling you guys, man.
Hell yeah.
There you go.
You know. And if you don't know what a cholo stands for chew only live once, okay? That's what a cholo stands for, you know? If you guys have YOLO, we have cholo. I'm telling you right now, man. You know, but let me tell you guys, man, what I love about being a cholo. I love being the good cholo, okay? That's what I am, the good cholo. Wanna know why? Because I always go outside and I make sure that everybody's car is locked. Eh? That's why I'm a good cholo, eh? You know what I'm saying? And it's crazy, man, when not having a leg, man. People ask me the dumbest things. A girl came up to me and she told me, Joe, can you 69? I looked at her like... I said, what? What do you mean, can I 69? She's like, yeah, can you 69? I said, no, I can 67. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, much love to everybody out there, man. Thank
Joe and Cholo, hold on, Joe, before you leave, check this out, people. Show some love for Joe and Cholo.
Yeah. All right. Don't forget, man, support the good Cholo, man. Look at the end of my song.
Hell yeah. Tommy's out there. Saludos, Raider Tommy.
What's up to Raider Tommy?
Hell yeah.
Raider Tommy, Chicano
Strut. Hell yeah, Chicano Strut.
Buy them a Chicano Strut, man. Buy your shirts now. He has every size. Yeah, 3 to 4X, man.
That's it, man. You know, dropping the soap. Joe Narez, saludos, brother. Shanna, what's happening? Hell yeah. I'm jealous. I want a song.
Just to let you guys know real quick, man, I am from East LA, man. East LA. No, literally, east of LA. I'm in Fontana, man. Screw that, homie. I can't afford East LA. It's too... Even the roaches live with me. I had to tell, hey, they're my Mexican crickets. But for everybody out there, man, before we continue this, man, I just want to let you guys know, man, that today has been a bad day. Today, I lost my grandfather, homie. Today, I lost my grandfather, guys. Yeah, man, I lost my grandfather today.
That sucks.
Yeah, I lost him at Walmart. You know, because you know what the mask, you, I don't know who anymore, eh?
Just kidding.
He had my EBT card, eh? I was like, yes, homie, where you at?
DJ Alf wants to know, how much are your shirts, Joe?
Well, you know what, man? They are 20. I'll show you guys. I'm gonna put a shirt on right now.
You guys are going to message Joe. Message
so
Joe.
They're 20. They're 20, and if you're going to get the combo, it's 25, and you can get a Shanky, homie. And you, yeah, I got the Shankies. It comes rosaries, too, with the rosaries handmade by me and Grandma right there, you know? You know, like I said, hey, remember what they said, man, you can take the homie out the swami, but you can never take the swami out the homie. Hell yeah, so let me go put a shirt on real quick.
Yeah, I got the wrong one.
All right, he's going to come put on your shirt.
Monique, right in there. When we do a dance, and we do it like work, like a cholo. Bobby Contreras, 559 by Visalia, California. Like a cholo, all up in the club, 10 deep, left us behind us, we on the creep. I need a Betty, saludos, Carmen, saludos, Colorado. Jess Gutierrez, Norwalk, California.
I like you. Henry, how do you have so many people in your house on a Friday night?
Hell yeah. Oh, we all tested negative, by the way, people.
Right here, baby. See, you got the George Cholo shirt, man, right here. Pass, everybody. This is your hood pass right here, man. This is the hood pass right here. Elbows up, touch a shot. Elbows up. That's right, man. Don't forget. It's crazy because my PO told me what I did positive. I told her to check my my drug test. Just kidding, just kidding. San Jacinto, where's all my Riverside, my Victorville people at? Saludos, Montebello in the house. That's right, man. Right now, man, roll call. Where are you guys hitting us up from, man? We want to know where you guys at.
Roll call.
Roll call right now.
Reedley, California. Bobby Contreras says, who's the cutie blonde?
Thank you. I shaved. Sorry, homie. You know, my roots were coming out. You know, I had the ugly roots. Hey, so you know how us Mexicans, we let the shit get black. Texas,
Mission, Texas. Saludos, Texas.
San Jacinto, man. Much love out there, man.
Mary de la Rosa, Ruth. Hers Media, what's happening, Ruth? How you doing?
East LA, man.
Adrian Hernandez, saludos. Nadine, Sacramento. Ronnie Verdure, what's happening, Ronnie? How you doing, brother? Freddie Martinez.
For my people out there, man.
Downey Hill.
If you're going to break up with your lady, take her to King Taco. Make sure you eat that red sauce. That way when you cry, she seems like you really care. I can't be with you. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you, that red sauce works, homie. That's how you sit there and do it, man. That red sauce, woo! Mm-hmm. No joke, it's the leg.
Nina Garza, happy birthday, Nina Garza. DJ Nina in the house.
For my birthday people, remember, you're 21 for the shipping and handling, homies.
Hell yeah.
That's right. That's a lot of shipping. That's a lot of shipping, right? San Bernardino in the house. What's up, Michigan? Whoa.
Big shout out to Hertz Media, which they did donate three art drawings.
Yeah, not only that, man, to, you know, like I said, I donated some shirts too. Relentless, what's up, Relentless? And you know what I'm saying? He's not on right now, but he will be on, man.
Shout out to Relentless.
Ghetto Currency.
What's your name, Payasa?
Payasa too, man. Much love to Payasa. You know, much love to everybody out there, man. The homie Creeper, he's not donating nothing, but he's the homie, you know?
Baseball head.
He will, but don't worry. We'll make us some stickers or something. Eh? That's right.
Hey, my lord.
Hey.
Chick, what's happening? Saludos. Blanca Maldonado, Juco Town. Saludos.
Seaside
in the house. Richard McGinnis. Rick McGinnis, what's happening? Monique, what's happening? Hell yeah. Carmen Gonzalez. Saludos. Boogie Down Bronx in the house. Hell yeah. East Coast to West Coast.
You got the Yuma, Arizona.
Carmen Gonzalez. Julie DeHaro says, hi, Susie. San Fernando, Kathy Mares. California, hell yeah. New York in the house, Lydia, saludos. Louis Vallejo, what's happening, brother? Saludos, Victoria, saludos. Yolanda Nieto, Seaside, California. Creepers on TikTok. Jerita, ¿cómo estás?
Don't forget, guys, to check out Little Puppet and Wi-Fi on the Show Lows. That's right, Show Lows, man. That's our Muppet show we have. We're us Muppets. We do a movie critics, man. It's all comedy and it's all love, homie. So check out the Show Lows, homie. You don't want to miss it, homie. And if you do, catch up, homie. You know? I tried out for the movie, for the TV show Cobra Kai, but they're like, sweep the leg, and they took my leg. Damn bastards. When people ask me how I lost my leg, I tell them, in the army. They're like, really? Yeah, in the Salvation Army.
Yeah, that's right, we're talking about. Don't forget the Show Lost. That's right, you can find us on YouTube. It's the Show Lost, not the Cholos, right? Even though we're cholos, we're the cholos, that's right. But we're movie critics, we look at movies and then we cap on them, we clown them, we make fun of them, we make the people cry.
Yeah.
So that's my favorite movie, how dare you? So anybody out there, what was your favorite movie and what movie would you like Wi-Fi and Little Puppet to interview? Which movie would you like us to, which one? The Karate Kid, wax on, wax out.
You got the soap too. Wax
oh, yeah,
wax
there it
out.
Is, man. The soap. That's right. We got everything. So, yeah, you got to look us up, man. And don't forget, man, we're going to be starting doing this. Because right now the quarantine, you know, got us all in lockdown and everything. I mean, I've been in lockdown for a long time. I only can make so many shanks in my room, you know what I mean? I got tired of making shanks, man, you know? But anyway, George Cholo's selling shankies, right, Joe?
I saw shankies. Hey, stab with style. That's what I say, man. You know what? You can blame it on the shankies and say, you know what? He made me do it. He made me do it. I'm telling you guys right now. The shanky works, homie.
Yeah, you know what? This quarantine's messing up a lot of us, you know. As you know that I'm not only a comedian, I'm also a pastor and ordained minister. So people were telling me, can you come and pray for me? Well, I don't know. I got creative. I go, can I keep my distance? So I made this, right? Look. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Right? So I won't get the quarantine virus. In Jesus' name, heal them. So that's what I'm doing. I'm a minister. I also marry and bury.
He does it, man. He does it all, homie.
That's right. That's the truth. So if you want to get married, let me know. And
it's two for one. Remember, two for one. He marries you, and then Right away, afterwards, he buries you, because that's it, homie.
Yeah, because being married is like being buried, right?
That's it, homie. Can't look nowhere else. You gotta, you're always going to be 6 feet under.
That's right. But yeah, you know what? We are doing this fundraiser, like I said, to help out Joe and Chola. We can't say this enough. If you guys really, really can support this, go ahead and do it. Maybe you're saying, oh, well, I'm saving it to go to McDonald's. I'm going to let my old lady supersize it. Well, you know what? Forget about supersizing it and support this man right here, this young guy. Right here, Joe Cholo is, what? How old are you, Joe?
21 plus shipping and handling.
Oh, 21 plus shipping and handling, huh?
Why are you putting me out there, man? I can't tell you my real age.
I got calzones older than you, man. I got calzones older than you. Anyway, you know, but yeah, so, you know, support
anybody
him.
Out there that has a piñata that fits me, I'm taking it.
All right.
Make sure it comes with candy.
candy. Who remembers the 8-ball?
The 8-ball?
The magic 8-ball.
Oh, that 8-ball.
Who remembers? Who remembers smoking an 8-ball? The magic 8-ball, right?
Ask the homie a question.
Ask a question.
And trust me, the 8-ball never goes wrong.
Okay, but you're going to have to help me see because I'm blind.
So okay.
Hey, Henry, ask that magic 8-ball question. What is the question you want to ask him?
Don't put me on the spot, man.
Come on, Henry.
Will I be alive next year this time?
Will he be alive?
All right, let's see.
Let's see what it says. A ver. Magic 8-ball says.
I'm just looking.
Wait, we got to put the light on.
The wrong one.
What is it?
Charlie Perez, what's happening?
How do you donate?
It is precisely so.
What's that?
So you will be alive.
Hell yeah.
At this time, right? You might be asleep, but you will be alive, right? So yeah, anybody else has a question for the Magic 8-Ball?
You guys got a question out there for the Magic 8-Ball?
Ask that, yes. Anybody out there has a question, you know?
Louis Moreno, what's
remember that calling me now? What was her name? That lady, that Jamaican girl, call me now. That you remember that one? Call me now. Or Walter Mercado. Walter Mercado, remember Walter Mercado?
He's a Cholo Mercado.
He's a Cholo. He works at a Mercadito. Anybody has a question?
Huh? El Mercadito.
El Mercadito. So you have a question for the Magic 8-Ball? This is only for entertainment, right? So don't think, oh my God, they said I'm going to get rich. Or whatever, you know.
Lydia wants to know if she'll win the lotto.
Uh-oh. Okay.
How do you donate? You guys go to my page. Go to Blanca's page. I'm going to put it up right now. You guys can check it out. I'm going to share it with Henry. That way I can show you guys where you guys can donate, what number to call, what number. So for any
you
guys out
you
there,
guys can donate to the GoFundMe. Go on GoFundMe and just look up Joe El Cholo fundraiser and it will be on there. Promise. And then also for the raffle, you guys can go ahead and purchase the tickets. You could either contact Joe and Zell Venmo him. Post it up after this. And you could either Zell or Venmo me, and then you gotta put your name on there, let us know who you are, so that way we can also include you. Not only in the raffle, if you're donating, also we'll include you in the raffle. So yeah, so GoFundMe, Joe El Cholo Fundraiser.
Hell yeah, you got that, people? GoFundMe, go look up Joe El Cholo, you hit that right there. You go to GoFundMe.com, search Joe El Cholo. This guy's GoFundMe will come up. You guys offer good ties, man. Good ties.
The GoFundMe is for to go find me because that money, I'm going to go party, guys.
Ask later. It's asking if you're going to hit the lotto. It says, ask later. Pretty much likely, Charlie. So ask later. We'll ask him again in a little bit.
So somebody asked. To ask your Magic 8-Ball if they'll ever get to meet Henry Lozano in person. Hell yeah.
I finally got to meet him in person. I think it took like 3 years to meet you.
Yeah, 3 years.
Johnny, now with Donnie, what's happening, brother?
It says most likely.
Most likely, people. Hell yeah.
Hey, Henry, just make sure you don't sure he's not a stop. They're not a stopper, right?
Yeah, that's true. I won't quit my day job.
Don't quit it. Yeah, don't quit it.
Don't quit it.
Yeah, so we're having a good time out here, you know what? And you know what? I sometimes I go to the clubs and I do comedy. And every time after I do my comedy, people are saying, hey, do you want a drink? And I tell them I don't drink, you know, because I haven't drank for about 25 years. I mean, beer got expensive, so I stopped drinking. No, that's not the reason I stopped drinking. Because when I would drink, I'll get all locote, get violent, right? And I'll get crazy and all that. And one time they threw me out of the club because I was getting drunk. So I was outside for about, can you imagine, Andrea, people for a half an hour looking for my car with a clicker. It wasn't even a clicker. It was a toe clippers. And I was looking for my car and like, well, man, where's my rampla at, man? Then I realized I came on the bus. I said, wow, man, that's how drunk I would get. I'll get that crazy and, you know, forget where I was at. But, you know, I stopped drinking because, you know, I just decided to stop drinking. But you know what? I drink a lot of soda. So if you guys have soda, kick down, man. I'll drink some soda, right?
Don't forget, guys, I stopped drinking for good. Now I drink for evil.
That's a good one. Hell yeah.
Hey, shout out to Araceli, right?
Araceli.
Saludos. Hell yeah. Peace and love, peace and love.
Hey, this basket's still empty, people. don't make me bring the shotgun out. It's offering. This is, you know, this is my offering basket for church too, man. So when it's time to honor the Lord at church, bacatelas, and they be giving big money, man. They be donating big time, man. You know, so, you know, because people were not giving. So I go, you know what, I'm going to get creative. And this thing really does work at church, man. You know what I mean? It does. All right, so what's going on here? It got too quiet, man. This is a party, not a funeral service, all right? Come on.
You guys want to kick it up with some music here?
Yeah, go ahead.
I know, I got a perfect song right here. Hold on, people. Hold on. Let's do this right here. You guys ready? You guys ready to party? Hell yeah. Saludos, Hawaiian Gardens. All the blues are badass, Edward. Hell yeah. Check it out, people. Hell yeah. Compliments of Blanca. Bobby D presents. Hell yeah. Share. Go to your GoFundMe.com. Look for Joey Cholo. Help a brother out. Help a homie out. Hell yeah. Mike Medina. Saludos. Laura Flores. Hell yeah. Blanca Bobby D. Nadine. Saludos. Hermelinda. Saludos. Hell yeah. Joanne East Coast. Irene Cantu, saludos, Silvia Martinez. Everyone's not taking a break. Give me some garage only style. Hell yeah. Everybody show some love for little puppy.
That's right. in the house.
Nice man.
Looking fine as she can be. Hey, yeah, yeah. Cause you know I love my baby. Hey, baby, well, that's what I say.
That's what I say.
Shirely, saludos.
My familia is all good. Lay your head down in my town. We just wanna party down. I've got a feeling.
Hell yeah, Junior, hell yeah. Yeah, little puppet hanging out, listening to the oldies. Hell, Bobby G. Honey, saludos, Jose Leyva, saludos.
I just wanna ride.
Tamales.
Oh, we're representing some fresh here.
Hell yeah.
Fresh organic, you guys. www.freshorganic.com.
Hell yeah, there's Blanca styling right there, Molly. Hell yeah, Blanca.
They have a lot of different styles. They got men's shirts too. Go to Fresh Organic. They're one of our donations for Joe at Cholo's fundraiser. Giving away a Dodger blue Fresh Organic sweater. Go on my page or Joe at Cholo's page and you'll see all the prices right there. $20, you guys. Raffle tickets. Message me, message Joe Cholo for that, or for a GoFundMe and doing your donation, you guys go to the GoFundMe and go ahead and donate right there under Joe Cholo. Or you can contact us also for donations, and you can drop it off. Even, you can drop it off, we can pick it up, whatever it is that you would like to do. You're just going to give us your name, and you'll still be added to the raffle, you guys.
Hell yeah, organic. You got that, people? Go hit up. Blanca Bobby D presents Chicano Strut. Hell
yeah. You
guys
thought I was going to do something else, huh? Shout out to David Garcia, David Eso Sanchez. Oh, yeah, Kathy. Where's Kathy? Say hi, Kathy. Kathy, you guys, she's always won everything. Remember? Remember? She was like winning every single ticket for every concert?
Yeah, yeah. Kathy Mott. She's out there watching. Kathy Mott is San Fernando, California.
Hey, San Fernando. Ruth! Shout out to Ruth. All right, hey. Keep listening to the molding.
Eileen! Yo! Just checking out the show, Garage Oldies. Hell, Carlos, what's happening, brother? Kelly Limon, Chi-Town, the house. Which one, Eileen? Joe Cholo, Lillian Medina just donated $100 to your GoFundMe. Hell yeah. Lillian Medina. Hell yeah. Gracias, gracias, Lillian. Awesome, awesome. guys want to hear Susie sing? Bishop Gigi Guzman, saludos, brother.
Well, we need some more. We need some comedy up in this bitch.
We got Richard.
Oh, he's ready. Hold on, let me introduce you first. Properly introduced. All right. I want to proudly introduce to you guys. Are you good? You ready before que te arrepientas?
Salud.
Con leche.
Ooh. Hell yeah.
That's right. All right, you guys, don't forget, you guys can go ahead and donate at the GoFundMe account. For Joe El Solo, all you gotta do is go to www.gofundme and you guys can go ahead and add Joe El Solo and you guys can go ahead and donate right there.
That's right, guys. What is this? The
he's
ice?
Big oh, she's getting the ice.
Thank you. You can hold it. I'm about to do a show right now. That's how the show goes at Henry's show. So, guys, really quick, Henry. This is bananas, by the way. I've been to a lot of Hollywood parties. I've done a big event. I've never seen shit like this before.
Hell yeah. The garage owners, brother.
I love this. I love this. If people have not experienced it, they should. They really should. You got a no-legged cholo. You have a lady giving the chicharrones. They're delicious right now. Fuck, I don't know if I have a tetanus shot. I think I got an infection. Like, this is awesome, bro. I love this.
And he didn't even wait for me to introduce him.
Oh, no, Richard Villa. Richard Villa. Double
it. Richard Villa.
Give it up for Richard Villa.
Yeah. So, you guys can look him up. Richard Villa, yeah. He is a famous comedian, you guys.
Yes. I'm famous. I have a TV show on Amazon Prime. If you go there, called Sigue La Risa in Spanish. I also have Refried Comedy that you can pick up on Redbox or any other venues. I've done a lot of shit. It's been 20 years. But one of the things that really, it's weird because one of my best friends is Joe El Cholo. And I really wanted to be here tonight. Out of 20 years, and you would think, who's your best friend? Joe El Cholo is my best friend, dude, because I know he's never going to run away. He's always going to be here with me because I'll take his leg away. I was part of getting it. So fuck you. I'm taking it with me. See, none of you can do that. See, you have wives out there, you fucking give her a boob job. You can't take her titty away. I can take his leg away. All right, so. Thank you. Pick it up. There you go. So thank you very much, Henry, for having me here. This is amazing. You have an industrial fan and shit. This is fucking dope. When we were coming here, we don't know if we were going to get killed by the children of the corn or what the fuck, dude. I'm a city boy. I know. It was fucking crazy. Yo soy paisa, güey. Yo llegué a este país. Oh, fuck. Did I just fuck this whole thing up?
How about you don't say that out loud?
Fuck, we're going to get busted. Shit gets weird, though. So, wait. How much time do I have, Henry?
As much time as you want.
Okay. Do you guys want to know where I come from? Okay. So, this is the real true shit. So when I was 10 years old, I lived in Mexicali, Baja California, okay? This is the border town of Calexico. And this is the thing, my Uncle Hugo was a crackhead, and somehow he got a hold of these two fucking green cards of two kids that didn't look like us, but they were the same age. So on the day of Halloween, what they did is, they actually fucking brought these IDs, and they said, mijo, we're gonna cross you. They were gonna cross us illegally, man. On Halloween day, I said, why Halloween? Because we can put on makeup, fucker. You don't look like the fucking people on the ID. Now, the tough part is when you're Mexican, they're telling you, mijo, say trick or treat. And you're like 10. You're like, why? Why? They're like, they're going to give you candy. Fuck, we started saying it. Trick or treat, trick or treat, trick or treat, trick or treat, trick or treat. We were ready. When we got to the border, this is true shit. I'm 10 years old. I'm just like Dracula with huaraches on. It was weird, like Twilight, like, it was just fucking crazy. The guy knocks on the window and tells my uncle, where you going? My uncle tells him, aquí, a little boy, let's take him trick-or-treating, I bring him right back. We never went back. The guy shined the light at me. I just looked at him. He says, where are you going? I said, trick or treat. He said, what's your name? Trick or treat. Fuck, I don't know. I'm waiting for fucking candy that never came. That's what I'm telling you. We ended up in Compton, California. Do you know where Compton is at? No, it's beautiful this time of year. If you have not been there, go to Compton. You'll love it. Take your jewelry. Take an Uber. Walk home. You'll love that. Puro negro, puro mexicano in Compton. I love that shit because I'm Mexican, man. I grab a six-pack of Bud Light. 16 years old, the lady would ring in a and she would look at me. Mijo, are you legal to drink the beer? And I looked at her. Are you legal? No? All right, don't say nothing. They're going to get us. Shh. And I would walk away with the beer. Ah. At the age of 28, I married a Border Patrol agent. And I know people don't believe me. I know people go, bullshit, I did. Joe knows me. It is true. I'm not lying to you. And I didn't marry her for the fucking jokes. No, I met her at a fucking place, and I was like fucking making jokes. And this is the weird fucked up shit. Like, this is what fucked up life is about. I met at a comedy club or a comedy show in Calexico. That's the border town where my family's from. I met this girl, she had a big ass. I was like, fuck yeah, I'm gonna meet this girl. I'm gonna fucking get this. And I told her, hey, I'm coming back next week. My cousin's getting married. Would you come and join me? Keep in mind, I didn't know she was a Border Patrol agent. Okay? That Saturday, she calls me and she tells me, hey, do you mind if I get ready in your uncle's house? I said, yeah, come on in. Dude, I didn't know she was gonna show up in full uniform in a white Tacoma. She fucked up the wedding, dude. Everybody, the bride started crying. Oh, the groom started running. My uncle Hector took out a knife. Orale, tu puta madre, orale. He wanted to fight her. My fucking cousin Junior was fucking flushing the coke down. Fuck her here, bro. I mean, she fucked up the party. And you got me. We got married, I'm not gonna lie, we got married. I don't know, a woman in power just got me, dude. I was like, fuck, she knows how to take control. Nobody fucked with me in that wedding. Oh my God. So, I told her, you have to quit your job. She said, why? Because fucking, I miss my family. She becomes a sheriff, and the shit I'm telling you is shit that you can look up in my life. She becomes a sheriff, but she wasn't like a cool sheriff, you know, like the ones you have out here, like, hey, I pop cocaine home. You know what I mean? No, she was fucked up. Like, I would drive drunk, because she said, here, you drive. I said, bitch, I'm drunk too. What do you think they're going to give me, a fucking parade? What the fuck? I would be driving her, and I would hear, and I will fucking tuck in my ass. I don't know if you know this, dude, but it's like a Mexican defense thing. I don't know if you can see my ass up there, but we're in here. Oh my God. I mean, we tuck in our ass. Like, we tuck it in so hard, we can open up Corona bottles with it. Here you go. But it's tough, guys. You can't be married to a sheriff when you're a pussy like me. Like, I'm a fucking pussy, bro. I have a little girl right now. She tells me, Daddy! There's a monster on the bed! I'm like, let's go, bitch. There's monsters here. Like, I don't fuck around, you understand? I'm a comic. I'm not a Ghostbuster, bitch. We need Jesus in our lives. So, I remember being married to the sheriff. Henry, I don't know if you ever felt this way, man, but I remember being in bed 3 in the morning, and I could hear this fucking noise. Like, and I didn't want to fucking wake up my wife. And she says, Sheriff, you know what I mean? She's going to tell me, go fucking check, so fuck you. Fuck, I hope nothing happens. And I would hear, she wakes up, she says, you hear that? Nope, I don't hear shit. Was, I could hear it, go check. I was like, fuck, why don't you go check? You're the fucking cop. You're the one with the gun, go check. Over there. I'm the comic. If that motherfucker wants to hear a joke, come get me in. I'll tell the fucking joke. We all do our fucking job. You're the cop. Go. She's pissed. She's like, go, pussy. So now, Henry, I am walking around my fucking house. And I can hear this noise.
And the more I move, Henry, the more I can hear this fucking noise. And I was fucking freaking out, not because of fucking the thieves, but all the years of La Llorona, El Cucuy, El Chupacabras, all the stories my mom told me, bro. I don't know where the fuck this whistle's coming from. You know what it was? It was a fucking dry booger, dude. That's making a fucking... Fuck, what the fuck? Ah, shit. All right, guys. I'm going to leave you now. But before I leave you, I want you to know this. God is great. God is perfect. God is a great engineer. If you look at our bodies, look at the way it's designed. Look at our nose. The simple fact that our nose is designed this way, the brain will just drip down. Imagine if our nose was backwards. First rainstorm, we would all drown. Fuck! That's why God did not give men breast or vagina. Because if God gave men breast and titty and milk comes out, we wouldn't fucking feed a child. We would squirt our buddy with it. What's up? We would. If milk came out of our titties, we'd be like, where are you at, fucker? We would. We would walk in here with one titty hanging out. Where's that fucker at? If God gave men vaginas, people, we would learn how to whistle with that shit. We would. We would find a way. And that fucker wouldn't get mad. He'd come over, show me how to do it. Shit, we use it to open up Corona. Here you go. My name is Richard Villa. Thank you very much for supporting my best friend, Joel Cholo, guys. Thank you, Henry, for giving us this
platform. Hell yeah. Give it up for Richard Villa.
Thank you, Richard.
Hell yeah. Don't forget to... Good times. Videos, good times right here in the
That's
garage.
That's Richard for you guys.
Check out his videos on YouTube. He does English and Spanish comedy.
Hell yeah. Richard Villa. Hell yeah. Give it up for Richard Villa.
Yeah.
Good times right here in the garage, oldies. Hell yeah. Joe and Jola, GoFundMe.
Say it's no big thing that you found someone new.
Danny Alvarez, what's happening? Charlie Perez, salud.
You said I was just a plaything and you paid me.
Hell yeah, Charlie. Coral.
But you'll never find a lie, a love so true. Cause I was the best thing that ever happened.
Rosa Morales, GoFundMe. Go to GoFundMe.com, search Joe El Cholo. You'll find the GoFundMe page for Joe. What's happening, Charlie? How you doing, bro?
Like
hell yeah, Shorty. Everybody go share, share, and share, people. Garage Oldies. What'd you call it, Joe? The Hell Yeah Comedy Oldies Show.
Hell yeah. Yeah. Oldies forever, homie.
Poodles Oldies.
That's right.
I was the best thing that ever
Hell yeah.
So continue to donate to Joy Cholo. Don't stop. Don't stop.
We could have been so good, you and I. We could have been happy for the rest of our lives. But you threw it
Debbie Perez, Ontario, California. David Garcia, what's happening, brother? Robert Gonzalez, salud. Hi, Miss Sandoval, what's happening? Molly Herrera, saludos. Terry Molina, what's happening? What's happening? Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Katie, saludos. What's happening? Rick, what? Rick Galado. Molly says, hi, Susie.
I was the best thing that ever
Hell yeah, Joe.
To you.
Hell yeah.
Now I'm gonna find someone to love me.
Bye, Molly.
Someone to
Carmen Baez. Oh, Richard Esparza, what's happening? Hell yeah, Charlie. Some Elvio Cadena right there. Round two music. This is a jam, Charlie. This is a jam. Hell yeah. Molly Herrera, salud.
To you.
Gloria Love, salud. Some Elvia Cadena right there. Best thing that's ever happened to you. Round two music right there. Hell yeah. How about this classic, people? Carmen, that was Elvia Cadena right there. Little Puppet right there. Bobby G and Little Puppet. Hell yeah.
That's right, homie. So you better donate.
Yeah, I got a question. Where's Wi-Fi?
Oh, where's Wi-Fi? I think he got busted or something, man.
Oh, man.
I think he got torcido. He doesn't act right. He's hiding under Joe's leg. I don't know.
Which one?
Which one exactly?
I'm sorry, Joe. I'm sorry.
Oh, don't let, hey, Joe, don't let anyone get you down, homie. If they do, Little Puppet will be around. That's right.
Time out.
Yeah. You could go to builtahomie.com. That's right. Yeah. Yeah, I know. All right, I'm
You're only one.
Becky Dorn says, saludos.
And I'm so proud.
Sing for us, Susie. They're telling us, sing for us, Susie. You ready to sing, Susie?
Yeah.
Come on, sing, people.
Yeah.
Show Susie
come on,
some
Susie,
love.
Get down.
I'm laughing.
All right, here. Come on, little
pup. I am Hernandez. Saludos.
Sweeter than the taste of a cherry.
You guys, show me some love. Susie Moran. You guys want to hear her sing, people?
Yeah, give it up for Susie.
Who wants to hear Susie sing?
Que ripa la Susie. Que ripa la Susie, por los Susie.
Denise Cortez, salud.
Órale, órale, calmada, calmada.
Yo pensé que dijiste que rica la Susie.
There you go.
I told you I'm into Barbies, all right?
There you go. Look at, Rosa Morales says $5 for
a tatted Barbie with dimples.
Andale.
I'm a sucker for dimples.
Hey, that's what Samaina told me. She goes, hey, I want to meet you. And I go, well, how do you look like? She goes, I have long black hair. I have dimples. And she lied, man. She had long hair, but in her armpits, eh? And then she said she had dimples. It was gross, man. Poor Gina. And I let her supersize it and everything at McDonald's, eh? What a waste of feria, man. Anyways, are you going to sing Susie or what? All right.
Hell yeah. Show some love for Susie. Hell yeah. Whatever you want to do, Susie. Whatever you want to do. It's all good. It's all good. Hell yeah. Show some love for Susie Moran. Hell yeah.
How about some Supreme?
What are you ready or you want to?
I'm ready.
You guys give it up for Susie Moran. Hell yeah.
Okay, you guys. I'm not in the camera, but I'm right here.
There you are. You get it. Yes, you are. Rob Boz, what's happening? Whatever you want to do, girl.
I'm gonna slow it down.
Hell yeah, Manuel. I'm gonna let her sing. She wants to sing. We all want to hear her sing, people.
It's because I'm looking up. So
look, yeah, look right here. Is that too loud? You tell me.
No, it's not.
That's good?
Kind of loud, look. So the music has to be a little bit louder. There's no sparkle of magic in your I
Porchos, another one, another one. All right, we're going to continue the rolas.
What was up, Anthony and Joey? What's up, Anthony and Joey?
That's a gangster rola.
In your eyes, candy love.
Enjoying yourselves.
Well, Matt Legazpi's in the house.
Some good music, some good comedy. What else do you want, man?
Right?
Now, all you guys got to do is donate, give, support, man. It's very important that you support. You know, sometimes we don't have finances, but there's other ways of supporting. The number one way to support Joe El Cholo is through prayer. That God will provide his needs, that the money will come in that he needs, and I'm believing that that money is going to come in. But you know what? Before Henry Lozano comes, I want to share a little bit about my life.
You're going to be the DJ.
I was born and raised in East L.A. Anybody knows where East L.A. is at? Huh? I was born and raised in East L.A. right off of Atlantic and Pow Pow Boulevard. But it got too crazy in East L.A., so I had to move somewhere more calmado, so I moved to South Central. And guess what? I have a pit bull, a beautiful pit bull, and I let him go out. When I moved to South Central, I go, I got to let him get familiar with the area, the territory. So I let my pit bull out to go and use a restroom, and my pit bull took off for 2 weeks, man. Can you believe that? My dog took off for 2 weeks. When he came back, Chihuahua, man. Can you believe that? My pit bull came back looking like a Chihuahua. He came back all skinny. He was shaking. I think he got hold of some crack or something, because all the evidence were there. My Venetian blinds were bended. My EBT card was missing. You know what I mean? My jewelry. So I think he did get hold of some crack. So like I said, being born and raised in East L.A. was real tough for me, especially being raised without a father, you know. There's a lot of young people that are raised without dads. My mom tried to be a good role model for me. She was my father as well. She had a big Adam's apple and everything, man, you know. She tried her best. So when my mom did, she goes, "Mijo, I'm going to put you in the Boy Scouts so you could be around men." So I said, "All right, Mom." So she put me in the Boy Scouts. I came back crying one time. Mom. She goes, "What's wrong, mijo? What? Who picked on you?" Because my mom was real protective of me. I'll tell you how protective she was. One time, she was passing by, and I was at the park, and she got out the car, and she started beating up the dude. She took off, not her chancla, not a chancla, she had a huarache. You know that one's from Mexico with a tire track in the bottom? A 357 huarache. And she started whacking other dudes around me. Bam, bam. I go, Mom, what are you doing? She goes, I'm not going to let them jump in me. I go, Mom, we're playing football. She thought they were jumping me, but we're playing football. You know what I mean? So, you know, she was real protective. I mean, she put me in the Boy Scouts. And I go, Mom, they're going to have a father and son camping, and I don't have a dad. She goes, Mijo, I'll take care of that. She took off bar hopping, looking for a dad for me. Who leaves a six-year-old kid for 2 weeks alone? She didn't leave me no groceries or nothing. 2 weeks later, she comes back. Mijo, I brought you your dad. Meet your new dad. I go, Mom, he's not even Mexican. But Mijo, you're Indian and he's Indian. I go, yeah, but he's that dot kind. I'm the woo-woo kind. Totally different, Mom. She goes, Mijo, shh, that's all right. He owns a 7-Eleven. And I go, oh, my God, I'm going to have a lot of friends. He goes, excuse me, sweetheart. I told you I own a 7-Eleven. I told you I live on 7-Eleven. And my mom goes, get out of here. She goes, I guess you're not going camping, son. But that was the end of my life. You know, I was being raised without a dad was tough. I mean, I had no friends, you know. I was kind of, you know, like, not smart in school. And one of my friends told me, hey, you know what? If you drink beer, it gets you smart. That's how dumb I was. I believed it, right? So he goes, if you drink beer, it'll get you smart. So I drank the beer, and I got drunk. That's all I did. I go, hey, you said that beer will get me smart. He goes, well, it got Budweiser. Well, they didn't get me smart, right? So that was the end of that. But you know what? Being raised, like I said, without a dad was really, really tough, right? I mean, you're trying to be, my mom tried to be a good role model, you know what I mean, like I said. But, you know, it didn't work out, you know. She couldn't teach me how to, you know, to talk to girls, you know, how to pick up on girls. She would just tell me, just tell them, do you want to go around? Who remembers that word? You want to go around, right? Who tells that to a girl? Hey, you want to go around? That sounds dumb, huh? But that's what it was back in the days, right, in the 70s. Hey, you want to go around? That sounded kind of weird back then. It wasn't weird, but nowadays you say that, if you tell a girl, hey, you want to go around, they're like, go around where? You know what I mean? But that was the story of my life. You know, I was so bored, I didn't have friends, that the cucarachas turned to be my friends. And we were poor. I'm going to tell you, we were so poor that the cucarachas used to bring us food. That's how poor we were. And you know what I noticed too? The cucarachas in East LA are crazy, man. I mean, literally, they're crazy. You know the cucarachas, when you turn on the light, they run under the, you know, the refrigerator, they hide because the light goes on. Not the cucarachas in the barrio, man. You turn on the light, the cucarachas in the barrio say, hey, shut the light off, ooh. They're so crazy to climb the wall up and turn off the light themselves. That's how crazy they are. But, and I learned one thing, the cucarachas in the barrio are cholos. Going back and everything, man. They are cholos. They have barrios and everything. You know who their rival gang is? The Daddy Long Legs. That's who their rival gang is. Daddy Long Legs. Mostly their territories. The cucaracha's territories is in the pad, right? You never see a cucaracha dead on the floor, but you always see Daddy Long Legs with, you know, with a leg missing and all that, right? So my mom tried to get rid of the cucarachas. So you know what she did? She sprayed them with Raid. And you know what that was for the cucarachas? PCP. That's what the Raid was for the cucarachas, PCP. So as my mom spraying them, they start going, chew! All right, we're going to get PCP'd. Oh, call the ladybugs, tell them we're going to party. You know, and then they call the ladybugs. They come down, they're spraying us with black flag. Man, we're going to get all smoked out. But you know what? That's the story of my life. I'm Bobby G. God bless you. And you know what? Like I said, we're here to support this young man right here, George Cholo. So get up for George Cholo. And I want to thank you that are supporting us out there, supporting him, all right? God bless you guys.
Hey, Bobby G.
Yes.
You remember the word, let's scam?
Let's scam, yeah.
Let's scam.
Let's scam.
A lot of people don't remember that one.
Yeah,
like,
I remember
you want to go around with me?
That's old school. You want to go around?
All right, you guys. Give it up for Joe.
Yeah.
And Bobby G. And Joe and Cholo that are right here. And we're going to put some Matt Legaspi, you guys. He's in the house. Let's say hello to a few people there. Are we almost at the deadline? Shout out to Paulina Gutierrez. Shout out to Ren Carifa. Dennis G. Yolanda.
We have the rocket.
think it's very sexy, and I really love it.
GoFundMe.com and you just look up Joel Cholo to do your donation. And then also we will be putting in your name for the raffle, so don't you worry, you guys. You guys can be part of the raffle. We have three gifts, and you guys can go ahead and see them on my page, Joel Cholo's page. We will put them on Henry's page. Aww. Awesome, Ruth Hernandez. Thank you, Mama, for putting the GoFundMe link on here. What would I do without you, Ruth? Ebony? Henry, would you like to take back your seat?
Oh, whenever you're ready.
Uh-oh. I was trying to keep myself out of camera. Joel Cholo. Hell yeah, let's support. Yeah, it's a raffle, Charlie. Charlie Perez, you guys in the house. Charlie, I hope you're doing good. I hope you're healthy. Come here, Susie.
I missed you.
All right, we're gonna have Henry sit down now, take over his show back. Since I took over his show, I'm
gonna let Henry back.
Okay, Henry. I'll let you borrow your show back. Don't forget, you guys.
Yeah, give it up for Blanca, Bobby D, Susie Moran, hell yeah.
Yeah, hi, Mark and Reyna.
Matt Legazpi, what's happening, brother?
Richard Esparada.
Matt, when are you going to come hang out in the garage, Matt?
So you guys, I have people on Instagram too on my live. I'm going to give a shout out to Trophy_33, you guys. On the Henry Lozano Garage Oldie Show. Henry, let's give Trophy a shout out.
Trophy, saludos, hell yeah.
Shout out to DJ Laker, Rafa.
Saludos. Welcome to the garage, oldies people. Hell yeah.
It's the Blanca Bobby D show today. Nah, just kidding.
Blanca Bobby D. Hell, give it up for Blanca Bobby D. There you go, Blanca. Hell yeah.
Sweet, hey,
but hell yeah.
Shout out to Joe.
Joe and Cholo.
Ruben.
Ruben Chicharron. Saludos.
Richard. Ricardito.
Hell yeah, Rosa. Rosa says any dedications, $5. Donate.
$5 dedications, you guys.
Go to GoFundMe. Look, search Joe El Cholo. And donate, people. Donate. This is a homie, brother.
He's a homie. Don't forget. GoFundMe.
GoFundMe.
Garage Oldies Show.
Help
tonight.
Him out. Hell yeah.
Relentless hat here. You guys can purchase it. Go to his page. I'll go ahead and tag everybody.
Hell yeah.
We got the Chicano Trust shirt. $20, you guys, $20. You know what? We'll do $25. $5 will go to Joel Cholo.
Hell yeah.
All
right,
some more music?
Yeah, we got some more music. It's 12 o'clock. You guys know what happens when it gets 12 o'clock. Hell yeah.
You hear the work bell ring, and I march you to the table. You see the same old thing. Ain't no food upon the table. There's no fork up in the pan. But you better not complain,
Esther Flores. Hello.
You get in trouble with the man.
Salute.
Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight
special. Everybody go share, share, and share. Hell yeah. Midnight special, Reggie, California.
Shine.
Anita Trujillo, saludos.
Let the midnight special.
Hell yeah, Gloria. Gloria, love,
let
peace
the midnight
love. Narcisa, saludos, the Midnight Special, some CCR right there, midnight, little after midnight, 11:12:16 here, right here in the Garage Oldies, Reed Lee, California. Susie wanted a request, here's Susie's request right here.
All right.
Wow.
You guys got a question for the Magic 8 Ball?
The one that asked if she's going to hit the lotto, I said, ask later, we'll ask it again. We'll ask Magic 8 Ball for the one that asked if she will hit the lotto. Let's see what the Magic 8 Ball says.
Go over, Bobby. Take over, Bobby. I shall return, people.
All right, so let's see what the Magic 8 Ball says.
You guys ask your questions for the Magic 8 Ball.
It is certain. I guess you're gonna win the lotto if you buy a lotto ticket. You ain't gonna win the lotto if you don't buy a ticket, right? So, here comes Joey Cholo.
That's what I used to do.
So, ask the Magic 8 Ball whatever you want. So, we're here doing the fundraiser. We're raising money for Joey Cholo, as you know. We're trying to get the needs that he needs, pay his medical bills, get him I guess this will call it a leg.
A leg, man. Give me a prosthetic leg.
That's right. He needs a prosthetic leg. So we need to get him something good, right? None of that cheap stuff.
Yeah, none of that. Pirate leg. I don't want none of that wooden stuff, man. The last one I had got termites.
Yeah, so you know what? We're out here raising money for that. So donate. Go to GoFundMe page for Joey Cholo. And how else can they donate through GoFundMe, right?
GoFundMe, man. They can hit me up direct. I really want to do it, man. You know, like I said, we have plenty of options, man. So,
yeah. You could go in his Facebook and tell him, hey, Joe, how can I send you some money? Can I send it to you? You know, money's easy to send nowadays through what?
You got Zelle, PayPal, we have Cash App.
Yeah, all that stuff.
All that good stuff. So they want to know. Joe wants to know, will he ever get married?
Who?
Joe wants to know, will he ever get married?
All right, let's ask the Magic 8 Ball. So Joe wants to know if he'll ever get married, right? All right, let's see what the Magic 8 Ball says. The Magic 8 Ball says, outlook good. It looks good. Yes, I guess so. Now, do you have a girl right now? Or are you searching for a girl? And if you're searching for a girl, you got to be specific, okay? What kind of girl do you want? You know, be specific, you know, because you just say, I don't care, then you're going to get, I don't care. But yeah, but it says, outlook looks good. So yeah, you will get married. You will get married someday. So
big shout out to all my people out there, man. Rosa. Big shout out to Rosa, my lady, Isabel, my kids.
All right, Isabel.
Man, the boutique. You know what I'm saying? Cosmetics. Much love to Loretta Garcia. Love you, girl. Thank you for sponsoring me for GMC deliveries. To everybody out there, man, that has bought a shirt. Thank you guys for you know, reaching out and supporting, man. Thank you, Henry.
Hey, Joe.
Yeah.
Shout out how you get your shirts, man. Hold on, let me model for you.
All right, here we go. Project Runway. Here we go. Henry Lozano sporting a Joey Cholo shirt right here. Can you go to the left and to the right? There we go. Turn around. There we go.
Yeah.
So this is the way the shirts look.
shirt.
That was my
I got from small to 4XL, man. The biggest is 4XL for my fluffy people.
Oh, man, yeah. They got 4XL, huh?
I'm not that big.
What size is that, what size is that considered? Damn size.
The big damn. Right.
You guys go hit up Joe and Cholo and look for his shirts. His prison kid. What do you call it? Your jail kid.
My jail kid, man. With Shanky. I got a Shanky in there, man. It's a nice little package I got in there, man. You guys won't...
You got an envelope? Envelope,
envelope,
right?
Paper. We got. Trust me, guys. You guys don't want to miss out, man. My little jail kid.
Safety pin for the handcuffs to escape, right?
Yep, we got everything, man. You
there
know?
You go. So donate.
Ruth Hernandez, thank you so much for everything too, man. Erica, everybody out there, man. Thank you guys for, you know, for tuning in. Thank you, Henry, for giving us your platform. And,
you guys are always welcome here. Yes,
come on, give Henry a hand for allowing us to do this for Joy Cholo. Come on.
Hell yeah.
Thank you.
Hell yeah.
Thank you to Henry's wifey for the tamales.
The bomb, man. The price?
Hell yeah.
The bomb
is a bomb, right? Well, you know how come the chinitos have their eyes like this, right? You know why? Because they go like this. Oh, no, rice again. Sorry. Sorry, we forgot we have a chinito here.
Hey, I'm Mexican.
Mexican, right?
I'm hybrid. I only become Chinese when I feel I'm going to get deported.
Hello, no. Joy Cholo, no, yep. Not Cholo. I'm a churro.
You're what?
Churro.
A churro. Yeah, no, you know, people always getting mad at me because my Spanish is not too great. You know, it's, you know, street Spanish. And they ask me, ¿No sabes español? And I go, no, sorry. Well, ¿No sabes español? Oh. And I tell them, ¿No sabes inglés? Oh, right? But you know what, my Spanish is street Spanish, you know what I mean? Like, and what is the first thing we know, learn in Spanish is the bad word, right? And what is the people learn, the first thing they learn in English is bad words as well, right? But you know what, I have family in Mexico, and when they come, they go, ¿Y dónde está ese pocho? I'm not Mexican enough for them, so I go, next time they come, I'm going to get them and surprise them. So when they came, I had a bag of oranges. Had some pointy boots. And when they came, I was talking to them. Órale, ¿qué pasa? Ese licenciado, ¿qué ondas, güey? Órale, come on, camarada, ¿qué dices? And they go, ay, si sabes español, te digo. And you know, because I'm not Mexican enough. But what is Mexican? How do you become a Mexican? A Mexican is not the language. A Mexican is the culture, the blood, right? That's what a Mexican is, right, Joe?
I would hope so.
I hope so.
Or getting deported, that makes you Mexican.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. And then when you go, first thing we say, American City. Where were you born? Everybody was born at the General Hospital.
Yeah.
Right? Everybody that's always passing. Where were you born? The General Hospital, right? Everybody was born at the General Hospital. That's crazy, huh? Everybody's
for those that want to buy a shirt, just message me, and like I said, I'll give you the info for my shirts and all that good stuff. So just message me, guys, and I'll take care of you guys. You know, I got from small all the way to 4XL. Yeah.
Hell yeah. Joe, what's your favorite oldies, Joe?
My favorite oldies, man. Ah, man, they're all my favorites, man, because they all... It just depends how I feel, man. But you know,
How you feeling right now? What's your favorite oldie right now?
How you feeling right now, Joe?
I'm feeling good, man. So you know what? Give me some Delphonics, man. You know, give me some Hey Love or something, man. Uh-oh. You know, if you got some Delphonics or whatever you want to play, man, it's all my favorite right now.
Hell yeah! Go out to Joe and Cholo. You guys go to GoFundMe.com, search Joe and Cholo, help the homie out, people. Hell yeah! Jose Garcia, saludos. Hell yeah.
Open the door.
Joe El Cholo. He'll give you all the information. I'm gonna model one of the Joe El Cholo shirts.
Should be loving me. Let's go on.
Guardado, prayers for Patty Guardado and her hubby. They got the virus, people. Prayers for you, Patty. Patty is a captain at Chino State Prison.
And you might say,
Rick G's home. So the shirts are really cool. They're cool shirts. Joe and Joe. Talk to Joe Cholo, give me a call at 559 I forgot my number 356-0443 559-356-0443. Give me a call. Ask Joe and Cholo, ask Bobby G, ask, where's your buddy at, Joe? He's out there hiding. Give me a call. You guys got questions, ask the Magic 8 Ball. Hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You have any questions, you could ask the Magic 8 Ball, but you cannot smoke the Magic 8 Ball. This is not a smokable one, right? So, sorry. So you could ask the Magic 8 Ball any question you want to, and you know what? Maybe you want to know, is the coronavirus almost over? Let me ask that myself. Is this a corona epidemic almost over or what? Let's see what it says. Magic 8 Ball.
Hell yeah, Jordy. 559-356-0443. You guys want to call in? Throw your shout outs. Say saludos to all the guests here in the Garage Oldies tonight. Hell yeah.
So a Magic 8 Ball says, I asked if the coronavirus almost going to be over. It says, without a doubt. All right. So if it doesn't happen, don't blame me. Blame the Magic 8 Ball, right? But it says, without a doubt, the coronavirus is almost going to be over. So you know what? But you got to be safe. That's because I brought our host some toilet paper just to be safe. Look at that.
Hell yeah.
And that's two-ply, too, all right?
Two-ply, people.
That's the good stuff. You know, the first thing I noticed when the coronavirus hit, what was the first thing people were getting? Toilet paper. I mean, how did that happen? I mean, what if somebody said, you know what, I got to stock up on toilet paper because the virus is here. I don't know how that happened, but, man, people were buying cases and cases.
It's because they were scared shitless.
Yeah, you're probably right. But you know what? It's funny that the people that are born in the rancho, they're not used to toilet paper. They're getting the newspaper, whatever they can, the telephone paper, whatever. All of a sudden, they got to use two-ply. You know, I use two-ply. And when you're wherever you're at, you use whatever you can, right?
Scott's toilet paper, man.
Whatever you can use, man. I asked the little boy in the street, well, actually, little puppet asked him, he goes, if you don't have toilet paper in the house, what would you use? And this six-year-old little boy says, you know what he tells me? He says, I will use a towel. The little boy said that in front of his mom. And I asked him literally on the street, he said that. I think my wife has it saved. I remember that little boy? That's, if you would run out of toilet paper, what would you use? And he said, a towel? Yeah. He said that. That's crazy. But
most
you know
of
what?
Us would use a sock. Huh? We use a sock.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. All right, play the air guitar, Joe. Play the air guitar.
I'm an essential worker. I still gotta work. Jericho.
Born in the barrio. Born in the barrio.
Happy Labor Day weekend.
Happy, happy, happy Labor Day weekend. Just be safe out there. Be safe. Be safe out there. If you're too drunk to drive or lift, call your mom, your abuelita, somebody to pick you up. But don't take a chance if you're drunk.
Or just stay in the car. Drive. Sleep in your car, homie. You don't have to risk it. If there was $10,000 enough.
Yeah.
And they don't take food stamps. So a lot of food stamps, homie, you would have to use.
Yeah, so you got to be careful. You know, be wise. You know, even have a good time. Just be safe out there, man. Because you know what? Unfortunately, usually the ones that end up dying are the innocent bystanders and the drunk drivers. Not a scratch on them, usually. That's the way it is. I don't know why, how that happens, but just be safe out there, man.
Hell yeah. Jericho. Oh, I got the warning, people. I got the warning. You guys ready for part 2?
Oh, yeah.
Hell yeah. I got the warning, people. I got the warning. You guys ready for part 2? Hell yeah. Out of Fresno, California, Red Bone, Pat Lolly, Vegas. Jericho, hell yeah.
Wasted days and wasted nights. I have left for you behind.
Hell yeah, Shorty.
For you don't belong to me. Your heart belongs to someone.
Check it out, people. Susie right there. Joe and Jola right there. Bobby G right there. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, Leroy Houston, Texas.
I know that you're not true.
Fresno, California, hell yeah.
When I know that you're not true,
Valley Rose, salute.
And why should I call your
hell
name?
Hell yeah. Sheila Rodarty, what's happening, sister? David Garcia, hell yeah. David, did you get your package, David? You guys go to GoFundMe.com, search Joey Cholo, help the homie out. Defender, wasted days and wasted night. You know, a lot of people ask me, what's my favorite oldie? This is my favorite oldie right here, people. Check it out. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, David. Thank you, brother. Yeah, people, GoFundMe.com, search Joey Cholo. Every little bit helps, people. Every little bit helps. That's what I'm trying to say. Jose Morales, salute.
Delgado
and Michelle Delgado. Gracias.
They're the ones that made it for you. All right.
Hell yeah.
That's beating me. Hey, well, don't forget, homie, I gave you some toilet paper.
You take.
You can't forget that. There it is.
Little puppet. Hell yeah.
That's it, man. Two ply.
Brand new roll, baby.
Brand new. Yeah. Never used.
Not used.
Not used. Imagine if I would bring you a used toilet paper to eat cochino with. All kinds of moscas all over it.
Poquito pestoso.
I know. So don't forget to donate. The lines are still open. Remember the Jerry Lewis telethon? Huh? Remember that Jerry Lewis telethon? The lines are still open. We got two lanes open, so you guys could donate to Joe Cholo, you know, fund me page. Look him up, you'll find him. Text him on his Facebook and tell him, hey, Joe, I want to donate some payday. How can I go about this? And he'll let you know how you could go about it. He'll let you know how you could donate. He has t-shirts. The biggest size is 4X.
For my fluffy
so,
people.
So, you know, I guess that size is considered damn size. So, you know. And then we have the Shankies. We have
stickers. We got stickers. Rosaries. Homemade rosaries.
Oh, homemade rosaries. You know, him and his abuelita. Right?
Yeah,
they're out there, you know, doing these. Well, donate, man, donate.
Where's Blanca? Blanca's over there eating tamales.
she forgot about us.
Yeah, I know she forgot.
Here she comes.
She got involved with the tamales. There's Blanca. Hell yeah. She got a strut. Hell yeah. Blanca Bobby D presents. Hell yeah.
All right, let's give some shout-outs. Elizabeth Diaz. Emmanuel, what's up? Shout-out. Need 6 tickets. Emmanuel needs 6 tickets, you guys. Emmanuel, you need 6 tickets? Okay. You can go ahead and either message Joe or message myself at Blanca Bobby D Presents so that we can go ahead and get that money. Zelle.
Is there a number that can hit you up?
Oh, you know what? You guys can Zelle to 818-943-0101. Or you can call, text me. Don't call me because I won't answer that. That's the line, 818-943-0101. You guys can go ahead and Zelle the money. And you guys can go ahead and send me a text with the amount of money that you sent in, with a copy, a picture, or something of that. Hi, Johnny Jimenez. And Manuel needs 6 of them. Oh, 6 size. I need the damn size. Oh, what is it?
Size 6.
Oh, 6.
Oh, size 6. Pues,
I'm off to charge you for 2 shirts, homie. I gotta sew 2 shirts together.
That's $100, bro.
That's a 2X and a 4X sewed together.
Yep.
All right, you guys, I'm about to sing, all right? Me. Hi, Gloria. Hola. Shout out to Mr. Ricardito. Richard ain't paying attention to us.
Where's Richard at?
I gave him like a whole bunch of, you know, shout outs, but I don't know about him, man.
You guys want to hear some more funny?
There he is. Hey,
Richard.
Catch you on the replay. Wrong song,
folks. Richard, you ready for set 2?
Oh. Too bad for him, huh?
No kidding.
What did Ruth say? Oh, okay. Thank you, Ruth.
you don't understand.
Hey, that rice was bomb. That rice got me. I'm gonna come here every Friday.
Hell yeah.
Who made the rice?
I'm sorry, the rice is a... Who made the rice?
Who made the salsa?
The rice, that is delicious.
The salsa?
The wifey.
Oh my God, dude, that rice.
The salsa was on point, man.
The salsa was, I wanna dance salsa. The salsa was good.
Hell yeah.
So Richard, are you ready for another round? Richard's already. How about you, Joe?
You know what? Yeah, are you ready to take
the walk on the stand?
I'm ready to roll myself there.
Yeah. Joe, are you ready to do some stand-up comedy?
I'm here to do some sit-down comedy right now.
Uh-oh. Some lay-down comedy.
Joe, I'm sorry. Too soon.
He's going to run you over, Henry.
I'm going to run over your feet.
Oh, I got a story, man. I got a story. So when I was like 13 years old, I had a boyfriend, right? And I was 13. Oh, my goodness. Don't put that angle. Fuck it up. Boyfriend, right? It's really sad. Sorry, God. So he was in a wheelchair, right? And, you know, I really liked him a lot. I liked his eyes because he had green eyes. But, you know, he was in a wheelchair. And so every single time we would go out, we would go in a van, and I would have to buckle him, right? If not, he would fall. And every single time he'll be like, you know, he'll laugh because obviously, like, we'll forget sometimes that he'll be falling. But when he decided that he was going to break up, well, actually, I broke his heart. You know, my mom, she told me I couldn't be with him no more. So, but he found out that I was seeing somebody else. I couldn't be with him, but, you know, then I started dating somebody else.
That is right here. Joe is basically sitting right here.
Wait. I mean, I really liked him. But guess what he did to me, Henry?
What's that?
He tried running me over with his fucking wheelchair. Excuse my language, people. For real. He went around, and he had an electrical one, right? So there I am running around the neighborhood, and he's right there trying to roll me over. Yeah, that's what Joe's going to do to you. If you don't stop all those fucking jokes.
Yeah, I know. Too soon. No, you know what? Joe's the one that started me on this, man. We're texting, right, Joe? And, he was telling me, we're going to do a fundraiser, and I go, yeah, that's cool. He goes, I just want to let you know because I don't want to step on a... That's cool. He goes, you know, because no one can step on my toes.
Sorry.
He did, Joe.
Hey, Henry, I have a question to ask all your followers. Is this, man, when I was 18, I went out with this girl named Maria and her cholo boyfriend, like big buff guy. Fucking basically followed us. I didn't know she was still dating this guy. And he cuts me off and he says, listen, homie, I'm just here for Maria. And I open Maria's door. Is that wrong of me, bro? Is that wrong of me? I mean, like, why, who am I to be in fucking, you know, pretend, but you know, their love, you know? I gotta let them have their love, man. I just opened the door and said, fuck it, that's a 2x4, bitch. You can fucking hit me. I just met you yesterday, Maria. You understand? I don't need this in my life. Is that wrong of me? I just want to ask them.
Hell no.
Thank you, Henry. Thank you.
Nah, you give back stolen property, dog. That was stolen property, homie. Shit.
I didn't know, bro. Fuck, it didn't have a serial number or nothing. It had stretch marks. I should have fucking said something.
I like the cholo stretch marks, eh? Because it always throws a gang sign and shit, eh? Yeah? They always throwing gang signs.
You know how many Marias are answering you right now, Henry? Going, that was me!
Jingle.
Let me tell you guys a quick story. So, I met Richard. I was jacking his car. No lie, I was in the moving business, you know? I was moving the shit around. So, we became friends, because, you know, I didn't steal this car, just sold it back because I'm a Swami Cholo. Remember that? I saw refurbished Chihuahuas. Okay, guys. So he invites me, you know, TJ. He goes, Joe, let's go to TJ. You know, we're gonna do Spanish comedy. I said, just do it, homie. So we get in the car, we take off, man. And I didn't know in TJ that the cops patrol with their lights on. See, I didn't know that shit. So the cop got behind us, and Rich is like, oh shit, the cops. So I'm thinking like, damn, dude, like, I have cocaine in my fucking pocket, you know? It wasn't mine, you know?
He was holding it for somebody.
It was my grandma.
It for was a her, friend.
Yeah, grandma's. So the cop got behind us. So the only thing I can do was I shoved it on my ass, like, you know, I kissed it, I had to. And then I see the cop go around us and it took off and I'm like, what happened? He's like, oh, Dick, I just played with you. That's the way they patrol. You know how many times, dude, my girl was eating my ass to sniff my ass for baking powder? Yes, right. I just get that.
The smelliest coke I've ever had in my life. He said, this coke's the shit.
That's,
no
the, that's
shit.
That coke that you go, oof. People out there that are single, guys, I want to let you guys know how to be cholomantic. Cholomantic. This is what you do to be cholomantic. Now, you look at the finest girl, and you approach her, and you say something romantic like, hey, what's up, ugly? And you have to insult women nowadays. I'm telling you guys, insulting them is how you get their attention. If you go up to a woman, and you're like, what's up, beautiful? What's your first reaction? Ew, disgusting. Like, who the hell are you calling beautiful? Don't you know I have a complex? Fuck that. You know what I'm saying? So, that's why you insult him. So I insult him. Like, oh, hell no. Why did you say, like, why are you insulting me? And I said, girl, because I just wanted your attention. She's like, what? What do you want? I said, I just want to know, is your father retarded? And she looked at me. She's like, what? Why would you say that? I'm like, girl, because you're special. And little did I know we both were recording.
Henry, how many people are seeing this? Are people in Fresno seeing this?
Fresno, there's all Fresno? Over the place, man.
Yes?
We got
okay.
East Coast to the West Coast.
Because the last time I was here, it was the last time. Really? Can I tell them, bro?
I don't.
All right, bro. Okay, so remember I told you I was married to a Border Patrol agent? Okay. So, I got divorced. Okay. Got divorced with the Border Patrol agent, and my life went to shit. I mean, I was making so much money, my life went to shit, and to the point where my manager told me, hey, all we got is Fresno. No offense to Fresno, I'm just saying. He said, the only club that would accept you now is a fucking club in Fresno, and I'm not going to say the name of the club, because I want to protect you, but I was in a very dark place in my life, okay? So we're driving up to Fresno, and I told my fucking manager, hey, pull over, bro, pull over, I gotta pee. He's like, no, bro, no, they're gonna stop us. So we finally pull over, bro, and I'm peeing. And sure enough, the cops show up, and they hit the light on me. I said, what are you doing? I said, I'm throwing up. I said, why is your dick out? I hate to throw up alone. I don't know what the fuck is that. So he starts laughing and lets me go. So we made it to Fresno. So now I am drunk out of my ass and I keep drinking. And at the end of the show, I told my manager, we're going to fuck. And he said, why me? I said, not you, fucker. You're going to fuck somebody. And I am very good with my words, Henry. I'm almost like a poet when it comes to talking to women. So as I continued to go around the bar that night, I'd go to every young lady in the bar and go, would you like to fuck? No? Okay. Would you like to fuck? No. Would you like to fuck? Would you like to fuck? And I went like that around the fucking bar. And finally, I got to the end of the bar and I said, a young lady, would you like to fuck? And she said, okay, this is it. Two whiskeys, please. So that night, me and that young lady, we proceeded to, she actually told me at the end of the night, she said, okay, Richard, that's 2 in the morning, you wanna go fuck? And so we did, we went to her house. And let me tell you, Henry, she was perfect. Like, I'm a chubby lover. Like, I want a girl this big. When her belly and my belly touch, we don't fuck. We just tease each other all night. Like, fuck, if I can reach you, bitch, I'll destroy you. Like, I have to make love like this. That's how I make love. I have to tuck it in. Just to get it in. So, I love it, man. I mean, I love big girls. Kind of. Big girl, it doesn't matter where you grab it. Everything feels like a titty. Just close your eyes, bro. Oh, shit. I grabbed the back of a girl's leg the other night. I was like, oh, shit, is that a nipple? She said, nope, that's a pimple. I said, fuck it. Good enough for me. So, we were having a great time, Henry. And then she says, I want to pick you up. Henry, have you ever been picked up? See, that's the same thing I said. I've never been picked up. I said, fuck, this is my moment. I'm going to get picked up. Fuck yeah. And I looked at her like she looked like me. You know what I mean? So I was like, fuck it. She could take this. I'm going to fucking jump on her. And I jumped Henry. And when I hugged her, she went back. And then she banged her head on the fucking counter and knocked herself out. I was fucking terrified, Henry. I didn't know what the fuck to do, dude. I was like, wake up, wake up. I mean, we were just being kinky. I thought this was fucking great. Nothing, bro. She went, I did CPR. I said, can you hear me? I grabbed a piece of chicken. I was like, wake up. Nothing. I ran downstairs, Henry, and I want to say this to everybody because I know this, you know, cancel culture and this Me Too movement. I want to confess today. It wasn't my fault. She told me, I want to pick you up. Fuck you. All right, you caused this accident. So if you're out there in Fresno, young girl, that I met fucking about 12 years ago, I want to use this platform as Henry. Thank you, Henry, for allowing me to let her know it wasn't my fault. I don't know if you're still alive out there. I don't know if you're listening to this show. If you are, if you're going, fuck, that was me. I am sorry. I ran out of your house. I ran downstairs. My manager was waiting for me, Henry. And he's like, what happened? I said, I don't know, man. She ran back. She hit her head. I don't know what the fuck. She's not breathing. He said, did you try the chicken? I tried the chicken. Nothing. Nothing's fucking helping. So I'm freaking out. As I'm freaking out, I see her running out with my DVD, bro. And she said, you forgot to sign it. And she still had the chicken in the other hand. I was like, fuck. That's Fresno.
Hell yeah.
I love you, Fresno. I know you're still alive. I just wanted to confess this on your platform because I don't want the Me Too movement to come after me. Look, bitch, you told me you wanted to carry me. You knew what you were getting. Thank you, Henry, for letting me speak.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, I know that Rooks and some people were saying that they wanted to hear me sing.
Yes.
You I don't sing? Know how to sing, though.
Me, Blanca.
So me and Susie are going to sing together.
Hell yeah. Give it up for Blanca Bobby D Presents.
Yeah.
Susie Moran. Duet. Hell yeah. It's all good. It's all good. You guys get a camera shot. Hell yeah.
Fresher. Fresh and fresh organic, you guys. The fresh organic, you already know what time it is. You're feeling like a little smoke. Fresh organic.
Hell yeah. You guys ready?
Oh, are we ready?
I don't know.
You better make it loud, because, you know, all the neighbors.
Hello.
Let's wake up the neighbors. Hell yeah.
Wake them up.
The hell with the neighbors.
Ready? I got it
right
here. Oh, is this
second?
Yeah.
You know, make that camera make me look skinnier. You know? Hide the rolls.
You gotta show some blood.
Richard said he liked rolls because they all are like titties. Let me touch your rolls.
Show some love for Blanca Bobby D Presents Susie Moran Duet. Hell, you're right here in the garage, oldies.
All right, you guys. I'm a bit nervous here.
Oh, I know what's wrong.
Hold on, let me stop.
No, yeah, stop.
Okay. We're going to karaoke right now. Selena. Oh, what do you want? You want?
It's just like heaven.
Oh, I can feel
you.
I can't even do it like that.
We're gonna do that song.
yo sé que tiene un nuevo amor. Sin embargo, deseo lo mejor. Y en ti no encuentro felicidad. Tal vez alguien más de nada. Como la flor con tanto amor, me dices tú.
AB says, yo.
Hey, AB. Okay, let's do it again. Boom. That's all it does.
Okay.
And I'm drinking with you tonight. We're doing AB.
Give me a thumbs up, Joe.
Oh, I gotta let this go.
Y te emociona, ya no reacciona, no lo puedes.
10 years old.
Oh, yeah.
We got the whole thing.
Bonos old. Show some love for Susie and Blanca.
Hey, Emmanuel says he doesn't like that song. This is the only one.
I'm trembling, I'm weak. we are doing. Not only will I never live it down, but my whole family relationship, it'll all be ruined.
Now that right there, guys, that was a performance that, you know what, that should make you guys donate, right? That
yeah.
should be a donation
yeah.
right there, man. That was a performance.
If Ruth is free. Yeah. If Ruth is still up, she's going to put the link right up. She's my side, you know.
Right
not,
there,
not
man,
my
like
side
I said,
chick,
man. Anything,
yeah,
anything counts, guys. Don't worry.
Side chick.
$1, $5, 50 cents. It all adds up.
Don't worry, Mario. I won't steal your wife. I promise.
Hell yeah, you guys go to GoFundMe.com, search Joey Cholo, show him some love, people, show him some love, hold on.
Hell yeah.
Come on, show me some leg, I mean, some love,
Show me some love. Chingo.
My favorite movie used to be Footloose.
Your favorite movie was what?
Footloose.
Footloose.
Oh yeah.
Hell
here we
yeah.
go, Joe. Hell yeah.
Show some love for Joe and Cholo. Yeah, man.
So Joe, if you get a new leg, are you gonna kick it with everybody out here?
Yes, I will finally kick it with everybody, man. If I get a leg, man, I will be Iron Man. I'll be the cholo version, Iron Man. To my people out there, man, if you have a prosthetic leg, do not fall asleep with Mexicans around. I woke up at the recycling center.
Hey, aluminum is like 98 cents a pound right now.
I was like, dude, you guys told me for $25? Yeah, man. This, no, the other leg, I got a, they gave it to me a wooden leg, and the termites got me.
Lemon oil, bro. What is it? Orange oil. Orange oil.
By the time I already ate through it, man. Shit. Fuckers.
Cochinos MC, salud. Hell yeah. Cochinos MC, motorcycle club out of Lindsay, California. Hell yeah.
Hey, did you know, Henry, that I was into motorcycles? Did that make me bike curious?
The cochinos might know.
Yeah. I was bike curious, guys.
Hell yeah.
No.
You guys go to GoFundMe.com, search Joey Cholo.
Get your t-shirts now, man. This is the hood pass.
Sauce.
With this, man, and you go to any neighborhood, they might kick your ass, but they won't kill you. You see, look at, bam, homie.
Right there.
I'm sorry.
Donated basket.
Hey, Joe, with that shirt, you go there.
Bobby G's basket of collection. Hell, you better collect.
Yeah. Bobby D, peace and love, brother.
You better.
Hell yeah.
Henry, you better put some money in here.
Oh, I guess
so.
Hold on.
Isn't this robbery?
No food stamps. Hey, you give me food stamps, it has to be double.
He's actually paying for the tamales we had earlier.
Hell yeah.
There you go. I made him cough up 20. Donation. Put him up.
I'm a poor Mexican.
A ver, Ricardito.
I'll take it.
I'm a really blow you.
Not in front of everybody.
What the hell?
They're gonna shut us down, Amy. They're gonna shut us down.
Hey, that came out wrong.
Blanca.
Sorry.
I'll edit that part out later.
Listen, hold my mic.
Hey, you guys, you know it wasn't serious, right? I'll blow him away.
Hey, Blanca, Richard thought it was serious.
I know. He was already like, toma el micrófono, a donde?
Yeah, exactly.
I heard zip.
He's like, I just stand up. You're that short. Toma.
Actually, yeah. I just did the calculations. Henry, it's hey, actually Felipe perfect says, size.
Rosa, I will not blow him away.
Rosa, me el palo. Thank you for coming in.
Sorry, you guys. That just came out wrong. Come again.
But it came out. Are we going to get shut down, Henry?
Not yet. If Blanca keeps on going, we might.
Henry, do you want to take your 20 back?
No.
Listen, if your kids are watching at 1 in the morning, you're a bad parent. Don't blame us.
Shit, I'm a bad parent.
Your kids should be asleep by now. Nothing good.
That's it. You know what? I got... Sorry, Joe. This money's going in my pocket.
Some gas money to get home, huh?
Henry, what's your bodyguard?
Bobby G.
What's that?
Your bodyguard. 20. What's his name?
That's Martin.
Martin, your bodyguard.
Martin out of Ridley, California.
Yeah, Martin's on point, bro. He's
Hell
here.
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah, Martin's on point, man.
Everybody out there loves Martin.
Yeah?
Show some love for Martin.
Hey,
Martin!
Martin.
Hell yeah.
He's on point. It's like, anything you gentlemen need, let me know. I got it.
Martin, we need to put you on camera. Come over here, Martin.
Come on, Martin. You guys see him. Guys, if you need to bury a dead body, this is the man you got to call.
This is Martin, the headless man. Because you can't see him.
That's his shy boy Martin. Everybody knows Martin.
Headless Martin.
Man.
Yeah, I blew your head away too, huh?
Russell, you're gonna be blocked.
We're gonna get shut down.
I know, blocked.
Oh, sorry. Oh,
people are finally waking up now. The show, anyways. We are the crazy people behind everybody in the show now.
We are the show. We are the show.
Hell yeah.
I took over for a few minutes. I was in your chair. I was like, after 3 years of knowing you, I was like, you know, 1 second in person.
Hell yeah. About time, Blanca.
I know. How many times was I live on your show?
Jingles.
A lot of times.
That's something that happens only here and in Texas. Jingles. Jingles. You guys say jingles. ¿Cuántas veces? Chingo de veces. Chingo. Chingo. Why chingo, bro?
Chingo bling.
Chingo. Varias veces. Varias.
Oh, varias.
Varias veces.
All right, I'm just an okay. Asshole now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chingo de veces. Chingo. Chingo de veces.
I need a beer.
Hágale una rueda guada, porque ya empezó a bailar.
Puro paisa, puro paisa right here. Puro moñonongo. You know, this is a paisa music. I'm looking for the India Maria. Where's the India Maria at?
Chicana Hernandez, hello. I show you guys my 3 year bottle cap collection. 3 years of bottle caps, people. Hell yeah. Bucktown.
Hágale una rueda, Juana, porque ya empezó a bailar. Esta morena cubana no va a ser hasta sudar. Baila como Juana la cubana, el ritmo que se siente sabroso como jugo de manzana.
Baila
como Juana la cubana, paso para adelante, paso para atrás, pero con nada. Baila como Juana la cubana, para seguir el ritmo te tienes que mover.
¿Sale? Oh yeah, Anthony, peace and love, brother, peace and love. We got Joey Cholo in the house. We got Bobby G, Bobby Blueson in the house. Little puppet right there hanging out. Susie Moran, hello. Hell yeah.
Hello, Susie.
Blanca Bobby D.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Rich Villa.
Hello, everybody.
Hell yeah. Garage Oldies, people. Always entertained. Hell yeah. Kevin. Hell yeah, Blanca Bobby D.
Block, I don't care if it's 1:30 in the morning.
It's early.
Still early.
Part one, Barra, part one.
Henry, se están robando los elotes. Se están robando los elotes.
Se están robando los elotes.
Little puppet.
Hey, she was cooking. She deserves them.
Oh, yes, right. She does.
That's how we're paying her right now, with elotes and chiles. ¿Quieres un chilito o un chilote?
Chiles.
Bobby G.
Hell yeah. Rick G. Tamale. Bucktown. GoFundMe.com. Search Joe and Cholo. Hell yeah. Happy birthday, Trish Toledo.
Happy birthday, Trish Toledo. Oh, happy birthday to my son, too, Carlos Dominguez.
Happy birthday, Carlos. Happy birthday.
And happy early birthday to my oldest, Joseph Dominguez, September 11, baby. Where's the security? That's what they're saying. Happy birthday, Johnny Jimenez.
Happy birthday, Johnny.
You look very tired, Ricardito. Bum, 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 bum. The show must continue with Henry.
Hell yeah. It's not over to the
Barbara. Elizabeth is saying, Lorenzo, did you block me? Laugh out loud. Love you, my friend.
Hell yeah.
You got blocked. Nah, just kidding. I'm playing.
That is Blanca, Lorenzo.
Lorenzo, that is Blanca. I am right here.
Right here in the garage, oldies. Hell yeah.
Hi, Lorenzo. We missed you.
Hell yeah.
Oh, no. I'm not going to forget to sign the board. Thank you, Nadine.
Yeah, you guys got to sign the board. Okay?
Happy early birthday, Leticia. 9/11 baby, Susan. Too.
Oh, Elizabeth Lorenzo says, no, I didn't block you. All right, you guys. I think it's time for me to sign the poster before I leave.
Hell yeah. You still got about 20 minutes, Blanca.
20 minutes?
You ain't going nowhere.
Oh, yeah,
it's not over till I say it's over. Hell yeah.
Who's the daddy?
Hell yeah. Oh yeah.
I'm gonna make my own song up.
GoFundMe.com, search Joe and Cholo, show them some love.
We don't need ratas here. Ratas de dos patas, salte del garage. Little puppet got down with Blanca. Hell yeah.
Oh,
you
can't look better, bro.
Gonna do Cochinos MC.
Salute.
Niners. Ooh. Hell yeah, Niners for life.
Oh man, that was a workout. Little Puppin really made me work out. I think I lost five pounds.
Joe Hernandez. Olivia Torres.
GoFundMe. Yeah, we play around, we joke. You know, he's been, the best thing that we can do is just, you know, look at the positive things. He's out here. He's still being a part of, you know, what he loves to do, which is comedy. And this is something serious, but at the same time, you know, we're doing this for a good cause, and that's the reason why we're doing it.
We're having a good time, but it's all for a good cause, people. Hell yeah.
Yes. And your donations will help him get another prosthetic leg, right? And
Where's Joe at?
He's in the restaurant.
Oh, okay.
But it also, the reason why the GoFundMe, I made it as well, and then there's another funding to it on Facebook that's going on. And on top of that, the fundraiser is so that he can also get a car, I guess the technology, so that he can drive and he can be more independent. So that's the main reason why we're doing all this as well. Well, here comes Joe. That's another reason why.
Joe, where you at, Joe?
And, come on in. So, you know, so he's been nothing but positive throughout this whole thing. I wouldn't know how to be, but I love Joe since day one, you know, and he's going to continue being one of my hostess at my events, you know, whenever I do it. We did it with Sly Slick and Wicked. We did it with the 10 Freeze. Father's Day
hell
dedicated,
yeah.
You know. I have friends, too, that we've done cancer events, you know. Things that have been happening. So right now we're over here for Joe. And we're over here with Henry, which he opened his door so that we could come over here. He's such a great person. Thank you very much.
Gracias, gracias. You guys are always welcome here. Hell
thank
yeah.
You to Richard. Thank you to Bobby G. Are you a pastor? Pastor Bobby
yeah.
G.
Pastor Bobby Guzman. Hell
yes.
Yeah. Little puppet.
And then we have Susie. And we have Gloria. Lorraine. Your wife, Lorraine.
You got Martin Biscara.
You better. The wife, okay?
The wifey. Right.
And we have security. Security, come on, come
where
on.
Where you at, security? Yeah.
All right, let's see. Headless? Oh, no headless today. Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, so, and we got Joe.
Joe.
Yeah, you guys are doing this to, you know, tell your friends. Those prizes are good. The first prize has, you know, I'm going to tell you guys because we're going to, we live far, so we're going to be leaving you. Sorry, Henry, I love you, but I got to go.
Peace and love.
But we're not leaving yet. Hold on. Yeah. Let me tell you. So we have...
Blanca, you ain't going nowhere.
Oh, damn.
Hold on. We're almost done.
And you know what? I'm a night owl. I am. But lately, I'm going to be a heat back.
We're almost done.
Okay.
Like I say, it's not over till the fat guy sings. I'll let you know what that is. Joe. Joe. What's up, brother?
What's up? Hey, man. Thank you to everybody out there. Thank you guys for my crew right here, man. Blanca, thank you. Susie, Richard Villa, Bobby Guzman. Ladies, for cooking, for coming through, letting your husband come out. Already? Yeah, and I asked, so she's like, yeah, you better bring me, homie.
And he made it clear.
My wife, eh? He's like, psh, yeah, because he's like, I don't want to meet God yet. I'm a man of God, but not yet. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
Thank you so much, Henry. You got the manager. Thank you guys for the food, the tamales, the rice. Everything was Bombay. Thank you to your wife for hooking
gracias.
Up. And ladies for coming through, man. And for you guys out there for donating, like I said, man, hit me up, Joe Cholo. Check out my comedy. Hey, it's only two legs, hey. What's that? You know what I'm saying? There's people in worse places. Hey, I could honestly tell you, man, that yes, it sucks. But there's people out there, man, that are paralyzed. People that are getting killed by the police. So I count my blessings and... I'm not going to complain, man, because you know what? There's still a lot of life to live. So I'm going to keep being a motivational person, man. And I'm a good cholo. So if the streets didn't kill me, why the hell am I going to let two legs kill me? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's all good, man, you know?
Show some love for Joe and Cholo.
Thank you, guys.
GoFundMe.com. Search Joe and Cholo.
I'm going to pass the Dolce.
Hey.
Susie.
Yeah, you guys. You know what? Share this video. There's other people that are in your family that are, you know, on your Facebook that is not watching this, and that way you can, you know, there's other people that will donate, and there's other people that want to get involved, and they don't see this show. So let them in on this good stuff, right?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. So I just want to say I have a show at 8:00. Every Thursday, and I also have people coming to my show that it's not just me, but there's other people, Norman Carter, and there's Joe and Cho. There's going to be other guests, but we were just waiting for all this COVID stuff. It seems to be like almost over, you guys, so stay positive. And everybody that says, you know, there's people still sick and everything, believe me, they're going to get through it because I got through it. And I know what I'm talking about. So, you guys, it's not going to take you out. You guys, we can fight this thing. We have each other. So I just want to let you guys know that, you know what? Buy a T-shirt. Buy some merchandise. Buy some shankies, you guys. It's worth it. It's going to a good cause. You know, believe me, it's not going to just nothing. It's going to a good... When you see Joe walking, you're going to be part of that. Okay?
Hell yeah. Show some love for everybody who came in tonight. Joe and Cholo, Bobby G, Rich Villa, Blanca, Bobby D Presents, Susie Moran. Peace and love, people. Peace and love. We're almost done. It's not over till the fat guy sings. Hell yeah.
I'm not going to sing, bro. I'm not going to sing. I already told you I'm not going to sing.
One more song, people. Hang out for a minute. Bobby D Presents, hell yeah.
Don't forget, you guys, I want to thank all those people that have donated. So I'm going to go ahead and post them later on today or tomorrow morning. I'm
gonna put all the prizes. Prize one, prize two, prize three. There's three prizes, you guys.
Bow your head.
All right, we're gonna pray for your hedge of protection. Get safe, get home safely and everything. So let's bow our heads in reverence to the Lord. Father, we just come before you. We thank you for this thing that you've given us, Father. We pray right now, Father God, for your hedge of protection upon each and every one of us, Father God. Protect us with your hedge of protection of your angels around us, Father God, that we get home safely to our destiny, Father God. And I pray for Joel Cholo, Father God, that you will provide his needs, Father God. And I want to thank all those that donated, Father God, for whatever it was, from the smallest to the largest donation, Father God. We thank you for this day, Lord God, you have given us, and that we have a safe journey, and we guard our hearts and our minds. And we give you glory and honor in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen. God bless you.
Amen, people. Amen. Hell yeah. Well, people. Like I said, it's not over till the fat guy sings. Right. Here we go.
Born on the bayou.
Oh, hold on, hold on. Hell yeah. Salute. Yo sé bien que estoy afuera. Pero el día que yo me muera, que
llorar.
Dirás que no me quisiste, pero vas a estar muy triste, y así me vas a quedar. Con dinero y sin dinero, yo hago siempre lo que quiero, y mi palabra es la ley. No tengo trono ni reina, México, siento el rey.
He wants to sing
Salud.
Una piedra en el camino me enseñó que mi destino era rodar y rodar.
Rodar y rodar.
Rodar y rodar.
Bien me dijo un arriero que no hay que llegar primero, pero hay que saber llegar.
Con dinero y sin dinero. Yo hago siempre lo que quiero y mi palabra es la ley. No tengo trono ni reina ni nadie que me comprenda, pero sigo siendo el rey. Hell yeah. Peace and love. Show some love for Susie Moran, Blanca, Bobby D, Joey Cholo, Bobby G, Little Puppet, Rich Villa. Where's Rich Villa? Hell yeah. Peace and love, people. Peace and love. Gracias for hanging out here in the garage all tonight.
Behind us. Come on, Glory.
Martin, where's Martin at?
Get in there, Martin.
Gloria, Gloria, security, where's Gloria? Gloria? Hell yeah.
Las cocineras.
Hell yeah, people.
Yeah.
Puro Pizza Garage Familia right here. Hell yeah.
Yay.
Lupe, what's happening, Lupe?
Get in there.
People, peace and love, people, peace and love. Gracias. Go Fummy! Joey Cholo!
Hey, hey,
go show
hey.
Some love for the homie! Hell yeah!
We love you guys! Thank
Bobby
you guys
G! Little Puppet! Hell yeah! Susie Moran! Hell yeah! Rich Villa right there! Where's that? Right there! Hell yeah! Blanca Bobby D presents! Hell yeah! Show some love, people. Joe and Jordan right there. Fundraiser. GoFundMe.com, people. GoFundMe.com. Search Joe and Cholo. Hell yeah. Joe, peace and love, brother. Peace and love, man.
We don't want to leave you guys, but we have to.
Yeah, the night's over. If I don't go inside, they're going to kick me out of the house. Hell yeah. Salud.
Salud con leche. Oh, that's what is it? We love you guys.
You guys enjoy the show tonight?
Bye, Nadine.
Hell yeah. Little Andy Rojo, peace and love.
Andy Rojo.
Peace
next time we get Andy Rojo.
Hell yeah.
So he can sing. Night, night.
Everybody show some love for all these guys right here that hung out in the garage all tonight.
Little
Pizza Garage Oldies Familia. Hell yeah. Joey Cholo, hell yeah. Rich Villa, hell yeah. Susie Moran, hell yeah. Blanca Bobby D presents. Blanca Castro, where you at, Blanca? Hell yeah. Chicano Strut. Show some love with you guys. Go support all these guys. Support the garage owners. Support everything out there. Support the La Raza. Hell yeah. Peace and love, people. Peace and love. Shorty, peace and love. Shorty, peace and love. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Salud. There you go. Peace and love, peace and love. GoFundMe, Joey Cholo. gonna show some love for the homie. Hell yeah.
Joey Cholo,
Sus. Hell yeah, dude.
And we take both cards, we take so fast.
Peace and love, people, peace and love. Barber Trujillo, hell yeah. Shorty, love you, Shorty. Hell yeah. Peace and love, people, peace and love. Puro Garage, Oldies Familia, hell yeah. Peace. See ya. I'm out.